This ketoenol tautomerism is also catalyzed by acid as well as base. Note down that point. Next point. Ketoenol tautomerism is also catalyzed by either acid or base. That means some base catalyzed reactions are there, acid catalyzed reactions are there. So we are going to take that one and see here. That is second order. Base catalyzed tautomerism. That means here base acts as tautomerism. So strong base. So here base is nothing but strong base now. Strong base, nothing but aqueous NaO. Aqueous NaO. Boys, all these tautomerism, all these conversions must be in a particular solvent. And without any solvent, no tautomerism takes place. Must be required. A solvent must be required. The solvent effect is also there. I will explain later. Okay. So generally here, water is taken as solvent. See here. A particular solvent is used, right? Aqueous NaOH, from this I am collecting OH minus ion, boys. This is involved in the mechanism. That is involved in the mechanism. See here. CH3, C double bond OH. I am taking, this is alpha hydrogen. This is alpha hydrogen. So OH minus, a catalyst is used. This OH minus collects this H plus as H plus ion. As H plus ion, now it converts into CH2 with negative charge, C double bond O, HN. So here carbon ion is the intermediate. Carbon ion is the intermediate. Now it converts into here and this converts from here. So that gives CH2 double bond C, O minus ion and H. Okay. So here H plus, that is minus H2O. Minus H2O. Okay. Next, this H2O. This H2O. H2O is involved now in the reaction. H2O now involved in the reaction. H2O means H and E. There is a slight bond formation takes place. That is water molecule. Because this one is partial negative charge, this one has partial positive charge. There is a bond formation. Now, so that converts into CH2, double bond C, OH, H, plus OH minus ion. This is our catalyst. Once again, in the final step, catalyst is reappeared. This is catalyst involved in the reaction. Finally, catalyst is coming out. This is our enol form. This is our enol form. So a keto form is changed to enol form in the presence of OH. This is base catalyzed reaction. This is base catalyzed reaction. It is the way to express how keto form is changed to enol form. That means our tautomerism may be catalyzed either with acid or base. This is base end. That means speed up the reaction. Speed up the reaction in the presence of strong base like NaOH or KOH aqueous condition. Next, acid catalyzed reaction. Next one, acid catalyzed tautomerism. Acid catalyzed tautomerism. Here acts, that is dilute H2SO4 acts as catalyst. Dilute H2SO4. From this H plus ion I am collecting was. That H plus ion now acts as catalyst. That H plus ion now acts as catalyst. So this is CH3. C CH3. C double bond O. Oxygen has two lone pairs. H boys. This is our H plus ion, a catalyst. A catalyst candidate. Okay, boys. So H plus ion has empty orbital. Now this lone pair is donated to this one that absorbs the H plus ion. That absorbs that H plus ion. Now it becomes CH2H, C double bond O, OH, oxygen gets positive charge, HN. Oxygen gets positive charge, HN. Okay, next. This converts into, see here boys, this is here, this is here. That interconversion is possible. And so that gives CH2 double bond COH. Once again, it is double bond HN. This is enol form. This is enol form. Okay. This is our keto form. This is keto form. This is keto form. That is enol form. So this is the way how H plus ion is entered. Now this one coming out as H plus ion, plus H plus ion. This is our catalyst. Once again, finally, our catalyst is reappeared, boys. Regenerated. This is acid catalyzed. Acid catalyzed. Boys, it is the first step, it is second step. This second step is a slow step. It is the rate determining step in the mechanism. In acid catalyzed reaction, loss of H plus from alpha hydrogen is the slowest one. Any slow step is called as rate determining step. So it is the rate determining step. In your previous base catalyzed reaction, first step end, that is OH attacking it, that is the slowest step end. Please note down that. In base catalyzed, previous example, first step is, that is OH attacking to hydrogen. That is the slowest step end. That is slowest step. Here, second step is the slowest step. Slowest steps are called as rate determining step. That means the entire mechanism of the reaction, speed of the reaction, mainly depending on this step end. If this step is fast, entire reaction is fast. If this step is slow, entire reaction is slow. That means total speed of the reaction is controlled by this step end. That is why that is called as rate determining step end. Here, second step is the rate determining step. In previous, that is the first step is the rate determining step end. It is a way to convert how keto form is changed to enol form. Okay. So in these two structures, boys, either acid catalyzed reaction or base catalyzed reaction, through the condition, see here. If enol form changes to keto form, reverse reaction is possible. Okay. This should be the intermediate. If keto form changes to enol form, this should be the intermediate. That means, whatever it may be, the reaction takes place either in forward direction or backward reaction. Forward direction or backward reaction. No doubt, intermediate must be same. Here? So, note down this point. Okay, what is that? Here, keto form to enol form or enol form to keto form. In these two conversions, intermediate is same end. Intermediate is same end. So this rule is called as, so keto form change it to enol form or enol form change it to keto form, this should be the intermediate. Intermediate should be same. So that principle is called as PMR rule. That principle is called as a PMR rule. What is that PMR? The abbreviation for this PMR is principle of microscopic rearrangement. This is called as principle of microscopic. Sorry. Reversibility. It is better to go. Reversibility. principle of microscopic reversibility. That means if the reaction is reversed, automatically intermediate should be the same. Same intermediate is there, that is called as PMR holder. So reactant to product or product to reactant, intermediate should be the common. That is the principle. That is a principle of microscopic reversibility. Principle of microscopic reversibility. Next, second note point wise. In keto form and enol form, whatever it may be. Okay, so in keto form and enol form, see here, number of sigma bonds same end. Number of sigma bonds same end. So count the number of sigma bonds. See here, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. See here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So number of sigma bonds same. Number of sigma bonds same. Number of pi bonds same. Number of pi bonds same. Lone pairs same. Lone pairs also same. But atoms positions are not same. But atoms position are not same. Atoms positions are not same, but number of lone pairs, pi bonds, sigma bonds, all those are same in all ways. And always these are same. Always these are same. And very, very, very important. Okay. So this is about what is tautomerism, what is keto-enol tautomerism, what is keto-enol tautomerism. At the same time, what is the mechanism of this keto-enol tautomerism? Catalytic reactions, either it is acid catalyzed or base catalyzed, whatever it may be. Catalyzed reactions. Catalyzed reactions. Very, very, very important. Okay, boys, is this clear or not? Tell me. Up to now, is there any doubt? How keto form changes to enol form, enol form changes to keto form? Is there any doubt up to now? If you have, please respond. If you have, please respond. Is there any doubt? Okay, now, next subheading, that is types of keto enol tautomerism. Types. Types based on migration of position of hydrogen atom. Based on migration of position of hydrogen atom. From where to hydrogen atom, where migrated. Based on that situation, what are the types of this tautomerism? So tautomerism broadly divided into two types. One is diode system. Note on this one. First one is diode. Diode system, very, very important. Which is also called as 1-2 shift. 1-2 shift. Or 1-2 migration. 1-2 migration. Diode system. And the second one is a triode system. Later I will explain it. 1-2 shift position. See here, boys. I will explain with an example. Carbon, double bond, triple bond with nitrogen. This carbon has hydrogen. This carbon has hydrogen. Okay, now, so this is first atom, this is second atom. These two atoms are directly connected, boys. These two are polyvalent atoms. From one atom to another atom, hydrogen is migrated. From one atom to hydrogen, another atom, hydrogen is migrated. Here, hydrogen is oscillated between two polyvalent atoms linked together. What is that? Here, hydrogen oscillates between two polyvalent atoms. Between two polyvalent atoms linked together. Linked together. That means these are directly linked from one atom to another atom. This hydrogen is migrated. Now it becomes C triple bond N H. Why? So it is nothing but hydrogen cyanide. No alpha, but it is possible. It is exceptional case. That carbon itself, this is our polyvalent atom. This is rarely it is possible. Okay, exceptional case. So here, from one position to two position, my hydrogen is migrated. That is why it is called as one-two shift or one-two migration. One-two shift or one-two migration. Okay, next. It is hydrogen cyanide. It is called as hydrogen cyanic acid. It is isol. Hydrogen cyanic acid. Isohydrogen cyanic acid. Hydrogen cyanic or hydrocyanic acid, whatever it may be. Okay, so therefore, from first atom to second atom or first atom to second, that is why hydrogen is oscillated between two atoms, adjacent atoms. That is called one-two shifted. Okay, now second one more example. It is example one. I am taking example two for one-two shifts. See here, POH. POH. It is H3PO3, boys. H3PO3. Okay. I am taking this one as first one, this one as second one. Now, this pi bond is shifted here. This hydrogen shifted from here to here. So, it is first, second. That converts into P double bond O, OH. H O H boys. This is possible. So between two atoms which are directly attached, polyvalent atoms. So this type of shifting is also considered as one-two shift, boys. But very, very rare occasions. Very, very rare. This is possible. But up to now, what I told, that is keto, inert, automatic, everything is a 1-3 shifting. See here. Next submitting triod system. Triod system. That is nothing but 1-3 migration or 1-3 shift. That is from first to third atom, hydrogen is shifted. First to third hydrogen atom. Okay. Here, hydrogen is migrated from first atom to third atom. Third polyvalent atom. Hydrogen is migrated from first atom to third polyvalent atom. Okay, so this is also called as a proto. This is also called as prototropy, proton transferrin, which is also called as prototropy, boys. See here, what have we explained? It is CH2H. This is C double bond O. What we explained now? See here, boys. It is first atom. It is second atom. It is the third atom. Hydrogen migrated from third atom to first atom. Now this pi bond, this bond here, this bond here. That gives structures, interconvertible structures. Boys, don't use the double-headed arrow. It is resonance, but this is not resonance, boys. It is tautomerism. This is reversible reaction. That is the symbol for tautomerism, boys. Don't use reverse double-headed arrow just like in resonance. Okay? So tautomerism is not resonance anymore. That gives CH2 double bond C OHH. That means from first third atom to first atom migration takes place. Third atom to first atom migration takes place. So this is what we explained up to now. This is our system is 1-3 system. Our system is 1-3 system. This is a triad system. So that means tautomerism two types based on migration of that hydrogen from position of migration of the hydrogen. So between adjacent atoms it is possible, or one first carbon to first atom to third atom is possible. So that is why 1-2 shift or 1-3 shift are possible. 1-2 shift or 1-3 shift. Okay. Now, see here, boys. I am taking an example. It is not types. Please identify this concept. This is types and that is the types over, boys. Please observe whether it is 1-2 shift or 1-3 shift during your process, during your conversion. Okay. So this triad system, all our keto enol tautomerisms are possible. Triad system, whatever it may be. So ethyl acetoacetate, acetyl acetone, whatever it may be. Up to now, what I am explaining towards your tautomerism, all those are 1-3 systems. All those are 1-3. See here, boys. What is this? What is this? Tell me, what is the name of that compound? Yes, correct, good, Rohan. Yes, no doubt. We all know this one is phenol. Now I am explaining here. See here, this is the carbon, boys. This is the carbon. This carbon bonded with double bonded carbon, double bond, and OLA. This is double bond, this is OLA. OH means, as per our UPAC system, OLA. So carbon, double bond, carbon with OH. Therefore, both en plus ol is there any. It is a phenol, is nothing but enolic formant. Phenol is nothing but enolic formant. Am I correct? Phenol is nothing but enolic formant. Am I correct or wrong? Because carbon bonded with both OH and a double bond. Phenol is enolic formant. Actually, what I told up to now, generally enolic compounds are less stable than ketonic compound. Write its ketonic form. Try yourself. Write its ketonic form. First of all. Note on, boys. See here. This is migrated here. This is migrated here. This is migrated to there. Now it converts into these two are as it is. This is double bond O. This is HN. Already one more hydrogen. This is keto form. This is keto form of this phenol. Among these two, which one is more stable? Among these two, which one is more stable? Yes, phenol is more stable. That's why this enolic form exists almost 100% and it is 0%. So that means almost keto enolic automation is not possible. Why, sir? Why it is not possible, sir? Because this is aromatic end. Aromatic gives more stable end. That means the possibility of enolic form depends on number of factors and stability of enolic form. That means the percentage of enolic form depends on number of factors. I will explain later. Now, boys, I'm trying to give some compounds, right? It's enolic form, possible enolic form, or ketonic form. If I'm giving ketonic form, write it's ketonic form. If I'm giving ketonic form, you should write possible all enolic forms. So exercise. Let us try. My question is, write all possible enolic forms of the following. Write all possible enolic forms of the following. Try yourself, boys. All possible enolic forms. Try yourself. Identify alpha position. If alpha carbons are there, first of all, I am writing, sir. See here, one example. Boys, this is our functional group. This is alpha. This is alpha. Here hydrogen is there. Here hydrogen is there. All right. I am using this hydrogen. This is OH. This hydrogen is migrated. That is why here double bond is possible. If this hydrogen is used, here double bond is possible. Here double bond is possible. Boys, among these two, which one is more stable? Among these two enolic forms, which one is more stable? Tell me. Among these two forms, which one? First one and second one. Among these two, which one is more stable? First one or second one? First one, and this is more stable. Both these are enolic forms, and both are possible. But it is more substituted. It is less substituted. More substituted alkene is more stable than less substituted. Therefore, it is more stable. This is less stable. But both are accepted. Both are accepted. And now, write like that. All possible values you should write. All possible values you should write. All possible structures. Like that. Okay, is this correct? Am I correct, boys? No. Why not, Swaran? Boys, both these are same, and single structure is possible. Yes, correct. Two are same. Single structure is possible. Don't write two structures. Only single structure is possible. Now, for this, it is OH. This one is possible. This one is possible. Two possibilities. This is alpha. This is alpha. this is OH, this one possible, this is OH, this one also possible, and two structures are possible, and two structures possible. Next, what about this? See here, boys, this is alpha but blocked end. Yes, okay, two is most stable, good, no doubt. See here, boys, here this is alpha, this is alpha, but this alpha has no hydrogens in it. This alpha has no hydrogens, but this alpha has hydrogens, so that's why I'm using this one end. This is OH, this is the double bond, boys, but this is bridgehead carbon. Bridgehead carbon double bond is almost not possible, and almost not possible, very low percentage, and low percentage is possible, very low percentage is possible, and okay, boys, conversion of keto form to enol form, conversion of ketone form to enol form is called as enolization. Note on this point, conversion of keto form to enol form is called as enolization. Enolization. This enolization is difficult. This enolization is difficult. Okay. Next, one more. Some more examples. Sixth one, right? Write down the structures, boys. I'm trying to write this one, right? I'm trying to write this one. For this, this is alpha. That is alpha, and okay. See here, converts into this is double bond. This is OH. This is double bond O, boys. Listen carefully. Between these two, there is intramolecular hydrogen bonding is possible. Intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Because of this intramolecular hydrogen bonding, chelation is available, boys. Because of the chelation, that molecule is very, very stable. Here, it is more stable. It is enol form. It is more stable enol form, boys. Okay, so almost 99.9% it is available, and that means among these two compounds, this is mostly available, and not like this, because here C double bond O, C double bond O adjacent are there between these two group. Here dipole ra, plus minus, dipole dipole interactions are there, dipole dipole interactions are possible. So interactions that decreases the stability. That decreases the stability. Because of that, this is very, very less stable. It is more stable because of that chelation. That means for this compound, enol content is more. For that compound, Similarly, here also possible, boys. See here. It is like this. So it is alpha. Or this is both are same, boys. That's why I'm writing. These are the boys. Try to write. I'm trying writing. This is more. This is less. Meaning forward direction is very fast. Backward direction is almost negligible. That is the meaning of the unbalanced arrows. Unbalanced arrows. Okay. Next, see here. CH3, C double bond O, C OH, double bond CH2. COH, double bond CH2, boys. So this is almost 10⁻⁸% is available. Enolic form is 10⁻⁸% is available. Because this is big, like this end. Like this, the molecule exists because of this. Because of this, it is very stable. Not like this, but because it is interconversion is not possible, and because it is ring. This type of interconversion is not possible. That's why it is very, very unstable. That's why enolic form is most stable. But here between this carbon-carbon single bond, free rotation is possible. Because of that, it exists like this. Therefore, it is very, very stable. That is why enol percentage is very, very less. Boys, did you catch my point? Which one is more stable? Which one is less stable? Here, CC rotation, single bond rotation is possible. The cyclic rotation in that sixth case is not possible. Here, cyclic rotation is fifth one, not possible. But here, cyclic CC rotation is possible. That is a molecule, this one exists like this. Therefore, it is very, very stable. So, keto form is more stable than enol form generally. Therefore, it is very stable, it is less stable. That too, less substituted ketone, enol. Less substituted, very, very less stable. Very, very less stable. Next, this is. Eighth one. Write down, boys. CH3, C double bond O, CH3. It is interconverted to CH2, double bond C, OH, CH3. That is enol form, Andy. That is enol form. Okay? It is more stable. Right? It is less stable. Andy. Almost 1.5 × 10⁻⁴% is available. Very, very less stable. That's it. That percentage is very, very less. Okay. Next, this compound. This compound, boys. So, which one is involved? Check once again. This is hydrogen, right? This is active methylene group. So this is like this. This is active methylene group, boys. Whenever active methylene group is available, that hydrogen is only involved in. Mostly, well, not only. It is mostly involved in enolization. Any double bond O. This is more electron withdrawing than this one. Any. Therefore, COH double bond OET. That is possible. Okay. So this is exists almost how much? Just 8% is available. 8% enol form. Next, in the same compound, this one is available. I'm taking. PH, nothing but benzene ring. PH is nothing but benzene ring. So, enolization possible. OET. See here, boys. It is almost 30% available. Enol content is 30% is available. Why, sir? Why that one is 30%? Why that one is 8%? Here conjugation is there. Here conjugation. So conjugation increases the stability, boys. But that there conjugation is not possible. Here conjugation, more conjugated structures are possible. That is why in this case enol content is more. There enol content is less. There enol content is less. Okay. Next. Tenth one, ra. This is double bond O, double bond O. Right, enolic conditions. Right, it's the enolic percentage. Which one is better? So both are same, and it is active methylene group. So use this active methylene group, and use that active methylene group. That is this one, and that is active methylene group. Okay, both are, that is possible, and almost 76.4% is available because of conjugation. 76.4%. Next, see here. One more example in that one. The benzene ring is attached here. The benzene ring is attached here. Boys, if among these two double bond O's, no doubt this should be the active methylene group. If this is involved, here pi bond is developed. If this is involved, here pi bond is developed. This pi bond has no conjugation, but this pi bond has conjugation with the benzene ring. Therefore, this is possible. And at this point, enolization takes place. See here, pH, COH, double bonded O. This enolization because of conjugation. Because of conjugation, that is possible. And almost 89.2% available based on that stability. Okay. Based on conjugation and more stable. But this one also possible, but very, very rare percentage. So less percentage then. Less stable. Less percentage, less stable. So like this. Like this, so enolization takes place. Like this, enolization takes place. Okay. So this is the way how to write enol structures when keto forms are given to you. Keto forms are there, enol forms how to write. Okay. Sir, I'm not understanding how the percentage is varying. When enol compound content is more stable, when enol content is less stable. I will explain later, boys. Okay. So what are the factors that influencing percentage of enolic form? So I will explain. Please wait up to that. Some factors, some explanations is given to you, but detailed explanation, I will explain it. Detailed explanation about the stability of enolic content, I will explain. Please wait up to that. Okay. Next, subheading. Types of ketoenol tautomerism based on functional groups. Please note down that. Types of ketoenol tautomerism based on functional groups. Boys, just a minute. Okay. Right. I will explain later. Based on functional groups, types of ketoenol tautomerisms. First one, types of boys, types of tautomerism based on functional group groups, not ketoenol. Types of tautomerism based on functional groups. Okay, note on this. First one, any ketoenol format. It is one of the types of tautomerism. Ketoenol tautomerism. Just now we completed. That is CH, C double bond O. This structure is available, any. So it is readjusted to CH double bond C OH. This one, any. This is keto form. This is enol form, any. That is why it is a ketoenol tautomer. Second one, nitro. That is NO2 group. AC nitro. Nitro, AC nitro. It is also ketoenol. One type of tautomerism, not ketoenol. Nitro. That is CH NO2. This is nitro group wise. AC nitro. This hydrogen is magnetic here. This is AC nitro. This is nitro. This is AC nitro. So this is one type of tautomerism. Nitro and AC nitro. Next, enamine. Enamine plus amine. Enamine and imine. Enamine, imine. Enamine means NH C double bond N. Because this nitrogen has double bond and amine group. Double bond and amine group. Yes, it is three bonds. Okay. This is fourth bond. So amine and double bond. That's why it is enamine. Okay. Now, this hydrogen, see here. This is functional group. This is alpha position. This hydrogen migrated from there to here. So now, this is alpha. This hydrogen to this one. Okay. See here. Hydrogen. This is here. This is here. That is CN. Double bond C N H. This is imine. This is called as imine. This is enamine. Imine and enamine. Okay. Next, fourth one. Nitroso. And oxide. Nitroso compound converts into oxime. Oxime converts into nitroso. Nitroso means N double bond O is called as nitroso. CH N double bond O. This is nitroso, boys. This N double bond O is nitroso. Oxime. This hydrogen migrated from here to here. That gives CH double bond N. OH. Oxime. That is oxime. Okay. So that is nitroso group is changed to oxime. Nitroso oxime. It is also tautomerism. Boys, this is 1, 2, 3. Triod system. Triod system. This is also triod system. This is triod system. Everyone is triod system here. We use it, boys. Next. Fifth one, amido. See here, N double bond N CHN. This is functional group. This is alpha hydrogen. This is alpha hydrogen. That is involved, boys. Okay. This is 1, 2, 3. To this hydrogen is migrated. Okay. That is N H N double bond C. This one. This is imido. This is amido. Okay. Next. Azo hydrazo. Azo means N double bond N compound. So N double bond. See here. Same rah almost. This is azo. Boys, take this one as azo rah. It is azo hydrazone. Azo hydrazone. That one. Next, one more. Diazo amine. Amine means NH2. Diazo amine, diazo compound. Or NH, N double bond N benzene ring. Okay. Next, boys, it is functional group. It is functional group. This is alpha. So 1, 2, 3. From here to here, hydrogen is migrated. That's why. This is interconverted to R N double bond N NH ring. That is the component. So amine. Next. Next and last. Azo and nitroamine. Azo and nitroamine. See here. N double bond N. Azo. Azo compound. Nitroamine. See here. This is alpha position. 1, 2, 3. From here to hydrogen, here is transfer ending. NH. N double bond. It is nitrosora. Azo and nitros. So nitroamine. Nitroamine. These are different types of. These are different types of tautomers, guys. So different types of tautomers. Okay. One last point, guys. Note down this point. Note down. I missed it just before. Okay. Boys, write its enolic form. Boys, please write its enolic form. That is keto form. Write its enolic form. Write its enolic form. One more. Write this one enolic form. Write enolic form for these two compounds. Ready? Completed, boys? I'm writing. See here. For this, this is alpha position. This is alpha position. Ah, okay. This is alpha. This is alpha. So this alpha is bridge headed. Bridge head carbon never goes to double bond. Here double bond is not possible. Double bond is not possible. Only this alpha hydrogen is involved. That is why its enol content is That is, this is and OH. This is with OH not accepted. Because Reddick's ruling, what is that? As per Reddick's rule, the double bond, this is not possible. SP2 carbon is not exist. Only that should be always SP3. Okay, this is possible, this is not possible. Not possible. Now what about this? Right, it's ethanol content? Yes, correct. So because this is block, no alpha hydroxy is there. So for this, no enolic form. For this, no enolic form is possible. No enolic form is possible. Okay, so this is the way how to recognize, how to convert enol form to keto form. What are the different types of tautomerism? So based on conversions, two types. What is that? Dyad system and triad system. Okay, dyad system and triad system. All those completed boys. So tomorrow we will discuss which one body. Just a minute. Tomorrow we will discuss what are the factors. What are the factors? No tautomerism. Because enol form is not possible, keto tautomerism is also not possible. Okay. So tomorrow we will discuss what are the factors that influencing on percentage of enolic form and different examples. Different examples we will discuss, guys. Okay. So thank you one and all. So bye all of you. Right now I am completing this concept here. Thank you.